Welcome to episode 70 of My Views Extended. I'm your host, Nadia, and thank you so much for joining me this week. Before I continue with this week's episode, I just wanted to get a little business out of the way. You can listen to My Views Extended on my blog at nadiadanella.com for the audio version. You can also, if you have a YouTube account or a Vidme account, those are both video platforms, you can also listen to my podcast there. I am not sure when I'm going to try again with the visual version of the podcast, but for now you can listen there as well. You can also listen to My Views Extended on iTunes and Stitcher. Those are all free platforms. And those are some ways that you can listen to the podcast. And of course, it will always be on nadiadanella.com if you cannot or choose to not listen to it any other place. Yeah, all of your shares of this podcast on your social media, if you text or you have a cell phone and it doesn't cost you money, you can of course text the link to this podcast to any of your friends or acquaintances, family. That is always helpful. And of course, any likes, ratings, or comments on any of those platforms will help this podcast to grow and be heard by more people. So I do thank you in advance for any help that you can give. If you have any questions or concerns, you can contact me. You can, of course, leave a comment under any of those platforms or contact me directly at myviewsextended@gmail.com. And I will get back to you as soon as possible. And as always, I will leave links to all of those social media sites and platforms in the show notes and description areas. And as always, I will ask that you please, if you have any questions or concerns, opinions, please drop them respectfully in the comment section below. I try to be respectful of other people and I just ask for the same in return. Today is awesome. I think I'm just going to be a foodie for life. I love food. I love sweets. But as of course, you know, you get older and you don't want the weight to creep back on. But oh, I am so happy that today is Cupcake Lover's Day. Now, who doesn't love a cupcake? Well, if you're a pie lover, obviously you'll probably not like cupcakes. Some people are strictly pie lovers. I am a equal opportunity dessert lover. Well, for the most part, but cupcakes, I love cupcakes. But you have to be careful with cupcakes because I don't care how delicious, how the crumb is, how the flavor is. If they're dry, if any cake is dry, it's done. Like if you have a cake or a cupcake and after 2 days, if it's wrapped well and it dries out, it either wasn't wrapped properly or iced properly. Like when you do cupcakes, I hate when you see cupcakes and they're like, it's like a, and it's just like one squirt in the middle and like you have a whole like perimeter of cake showing. Of course, it's going to dry out by the next day. I'm a little serious about icing, but I don't care if it's like cakes. I'm not talking about like a pound cake, but any kind of sponge cake, Victoria cake, whatever, regular standard cake. You have to ice it properly. It has to be covered in icing. Whatever your icing of choice is, it has to be covered. Cupcake has to be covered. The entire surface has to be covered or it's going to dry out. That's just how it is. I'm very strict on cakes. Ice them properly or they're going to dry out. I'm just saying, I'm going to stop ranting about cakes. But to celebrate Cupcake Lover's Day, I am going to send you over, if you're interested in checking out my recipe for cherry cupcakes with cherry buttercream icing. That is one of my favorite cupcakes to make aside from chocolate. That's on over at Nadia's Kitchen Creations. That's one of my YouTube channels. And of course, you can watch me make the recipe for cherry cupcakes with the cherry buttercream on Nadia's Kitchen Creations. Or you can just head on over to nadiajanella.com where you can get the printable recipe for that, for the cherry cupcakes with the cherry buttercream. And I love cherries. Those are, it is my top favorite fruit. So of course I had to make a recipe for cherry cupcakes with cherry buttercream icing. Are you guys doing anything for Cupcake Lover's Day? Let me know what your favorite cupcakes are. And while I'm here, I might as well ask the question, are there any cupcakes that you would like to see me make on Nadia's Kitchen Creations? And I'll see what I can do. Why not use this platform? They're all my platforms. So yeah, if there are any cupcakes that you would like to see me make, let me know and I will see what I can do about that. So happy Cupcake Lover's Day. I need to go to the theater to see, I need to see Wonder Woman and I need to see Black Panther. Wonder Woman won because I love that show since I was a little girl. I haven't seen it since I was little, but just, you know, you grow up and you watch it and you like, oh my gosh, okay, it's 3 minutes till Wonder Woman comes on. and you get your like little snacks and your cup, and you go to the washroom and you're set. And then you know like how she do that Wonder Woman thing, and then like you'd like spin around, and I'd spin around until I get dizzy because she spin around and all of a sudden she had off like her cape on. Okay, I hope that wasn't just me that did that. It was a really good show. I really enjoyed it. Anyway, I love Wonder Woman. I looked up to her. I know a lot of people make fun of me. I had a professor in one of my history classes. It was a history class, but it was also part women's studies. Actually, that was when I fell in love with history, was taking her class. She was a really great teacher, but we were talking about women and fictional women, obviously, and if we who was our hero? And I remember I was like, I love Wonder Woman as a little girl. I absolutely loved it. And she was my hero. I wanted to be her when I grew up. And she like started making fun of me and like laughed at me. Like, she's like, are you serious? You wanted to be Wonder Woman? Like in a cape. And I was like, well, and I was like, oh no, you're not, you know, just because you're the professor, you're not making me feel bad. I was like, first of all, I was a little girl. Like, I don't even remember how old I was. Like, little, like under 10, definitely. Way under 10, I think. And it was like, it was cool because she lived on this cool island. And obviously, I didn't understand the history of it, of the myth, but she lived on this island, and then she like had her thing, and she kicked butt, and she was like a hero, and she saved people. And that's what I looked at. It was just, I was a little kid, I was basic. I was like, cool, she's a woman kicking butt, saving people. Awesome. That's how I looked at it. And she was like making fun of me because I was a little girl, she was a hero to me. And as an adult, obviously, you when you learn the history of the Greek, the myth, and and the story, and just life happens, and you get to see it. Obviously, I don't see her the same way as when I was a little girl, but it was like, really? Like, you're making fun of me because I like it? And I was like, no, I still like it. I was like, you guys can make fun of me. And everybody in the class is kind of snickering, but it was like, whatever. I was like, I was, as a little child, she was a hero to me, and I don't care. So I'm going to see Wonder Woman. I don't know when. That kind of went off track. I kind of lost what I was going to say. But anyway, I just like Wonder Woman. And don't let people make you feel bad for liking something. Even if you liked it, even if you loved Wonder Woman as a little girl and you still love Wonder Woman as a woman now, don't let people make fun of you for what you enjoyed. There are many things that we can pull from what we like as an adult versus a child, and that's okay. I also want to see Black Panther. First of all, it looks really cool when they release, you know, how everybody looks and the costumes, and panthers are just awesome. And I have a little mini panther at home, a black cat, like domestic cat, but I call her my little panther. But anyways, Black Panther, and I just want to support like a lead in a comic based movie that's a black lead, and why not? And it's, you know, it's, we're gonna see parts of, you know, they pull parts of various African cultures, because of course there are dozens and dozens and hundreds of different various African cultures, and pulling from them, and just, you know, that's the main character, and there's just, why not? I'd like to support. Obviously, I support anybody regardless of their color, but of course, I'm going to take special note, and I'm going to support movies of people of color, because there's just not enough, as far as I'm concerned, you know, that have great stories, that have great actors and actresses, and great costumes and great sets, and a lot of money is put into them, and marketing, all those, you know, things combined, it just doesn't happen that often. So I definitely want to at some point. I'm not saying it's going to be immediately, but I do want to support that. So yeah, let's hope that the movie doesn't disappoint. And let me know if you have seen either Wonder Woman or Black Panther, or if you plan on seeing it. And if you did see it, did they meet your expectations? Was Wonder Woman as good as you thought it was going to be? Was Black Panther as good as you thought it was going to be? I'd love to hear what everybody thinks of either of those movies. I'm finally caught up on iZombie. It's on, I'm watching, I don't know if it's anywhere else or if it's just on Netflix. I have no idea because I don't have cable anymore. I've been watching it on Netflix, and I've caught up on all three seasons, and I absolutely love that show. Have any of you guys been watching it? I'm actually able to catch it on Netflix. Thank you to Netflix and to my sister since it's on her account. Thank you, sister. And of course, they end the last season with a huge cliffhanger, but I won't spoil it, so don't worry. But if you can catch up on it, it's so worth it. Well, it is worth it, but it's annoying because it's like I want to get to the next season and find out what happens next. It looks so exciting. I can't wait for the next season to come out because it looks good. And that's all I'm going to say. Okay, but I do need something else to watch. Although I have to say I'm very content with rewatching Supernatural. I love Supernatural. I have not seen the latest season, but I don't know how many times I have rewatched the show from season one straight through till everything that they have up on Netflix. I just keep watching it through, like, whenever I'm not doing anything. Oftentimes, actually, some shows, like, if it's a new show, obviously, I'll, you know, wait till I'm not distracted and I'm not doing any other things. But if it's a show like Supernatural, sometimes I'll watch it while I'm doing, if I'm writing something, or if I'm not even really writing something, if I'm, say, editing photos or, you know, doing something where I don't need to be paying attention completely. But yeah, I could watch that over and over again. I can't wait until Netflix gets hold of the latest season. I don't know when that is. I think, if I'm remembering correctly, I don't think they release it either until the beginning of the summer or the end of the summer. I know it's definitely before the next season starts up again in the fall. But anyway, I'm just waiting for it. I can't wait. Hurry up, Netflix. I love that show. Even though some of the seasons are not the greatest, or sometimes you get like half of a season that's kind of crap, or, you know, two episodes are awesome, two episodes are not so great. It's like, or they stretch it out too much. But anyway, I love it. You know, the not so great seasons or episodes help me appreciate the great seasons and great episodes. So I'm not complaining. Like I said, I can watch it over and over again. Sometimes I'm still catching things that I didn't see. I love the show. I'm not obsessed. Like, I'm not like going to, is it like Comic-Con or whatever? I'm not that obsessive a person where I'm going to those like conferences and Comic-Cons and stuff like that. Not that there's anything wrong with it, but I don't want to like stalk people because that's creepy. Although they do film in the Vancouver area. They film in Vancouver, Burnaby, New West, I think. And I think the studios are in Burnaby, I think, where they film in the studios. Anyways, they film all over. It's pretty cool that I get to see, like, when I'm watching older episodes, like, you see certain like restaurants or car places that they, or not storage units, but garages or whatever that they film in. And then you walk by and you're like, hey, that's where they filmed that. Or I ate it at that restaurant. It's kind of cool that I get to see that, because I guess people who live in like Vancouver and Toronto area, like whether you live in the Vancouver proper, Toronto proper, or you live in one of the cities around it, if you grew up there, you've always seen that. They always film in those places for years and years and years. And so I came from a place where they didn't film anything really. I think they might have filmed something for the Blue Water Bridge in my hometown. But anyway, it's just really cool that you can see, like, there's tons of shows that tape in Vancouver and in all the cities surrounding it. So I think I would maybe, like, if I was passing by, I would probably stop. But I don't know if I would actually go and seek out, you know, okay, they're filming in this park or area, and go hang out, like how some people like literally will hang out all day and then wait for the two, for Jensen and Jared to come take pictures with them, which are really sweet. Like, it's really awesome that they actually do that they actually take pictures with people who are waiting. I don't know if they should, oh, I don't want to put that out there, but is that safe? I hope they have bodyguards or something, because some people are, I mean, most people are not crazy. Most people are not wanting to hurt people, but it just takes that one person. But you know, praying that praying that nothing ever happens to them, and they just have people who really like them and they safely take a picture and move on and don't stalk them or anything like that. But yeah, I don't know if I do that, but like I said, if I'm passing and I see it, I probably will stop just to see, because I've never actually seen them film. Well, I shouldn't say that. I think I saw them filming once, but I haven't seen like the actual actors filming a scene, anything like that. One time when I was passing in New West, they were filming for, I think it was season one of Lucifer. I don't even know if that show's still on, but they were filming for Lucifer, and there was, I think it was just like extras, or there was like some kind of fight scene at nighttime. And what were they doing? Oh yeah, so it was raining. I think that's why I didn't stop, because it was raining. I'm like, I'm not standing out, because I saw the, you know, all the signs, and it was one of the guys, I think, I don't know if he was security or just kind of keeping people, you know, when they have, you know, they barricaded off a little bit. So I don't know if it was just his job to keep people from not going into the set and disrupting filming. But I asked him, do you mind if I ask, you know, what they're filming here? And he's like, oh yeah, they're just filming season one of Lucifer. And I was like, oh, cool, okay. And I didn't really have anything else to ask. And then, but my sister knew about Lucifer because she watched or watches Lucifer. So yeah, that's as close as I saw to anything. But there weren't any of the big actors, I think, there that day. Anyway, yeah. So anyway, if there are any shows or movies that you like, I'd love to know about them. What are you watching? I'm pretty much open to anything. Well, I shouldn't say that. I like action, thrillers, you know, supernaturals, you know, stuff like that. Comedies, superhero things, anything like that. I'm not really huge into romance, but yeah, anything that looks really cool, you know, or any movies. I like documentaries. I love documentaries. Yeah, let me know what you're watching and if you have any suggestions. I'm just looking for something to watch when I have days off, when, you know, I want to be a bed or couch bum when I don't have energy to go out and do things. In Vancouver, I was reading, it was with the CTV News in BC. Apparently, tiny homes are not legal in Vancouver. And of course, I don't know that because I'm not looking to buy a home. But a couple found out that tiny homes are not legal. And but he only found out after 11 months of living in this area. And then they got some kind of notice from the city saying that mobile dwellings were not legal. I don't have a problem with laws, with legalities. The law is a law, so that's not my issue at all. It wasn't really clear from the story, or at least from his side, about whether or not he researched to find out if he could, or if he just did it and hoped that nobody would tell him to move. So I'm not really sure how he was able to live there for 11 months, or if he was given the okay by the property owner. Who knows what it was? But anyway, he has to move. But the story did indicate that, you know, I think there are other places in the U.S., somewhere in California. I wanted to say the San Francisco area. I'm not positive, but somewhere in California that they have, that small mobile homes are a solution to the growing problem of not having affordable housing. And then the affordable housing that is available, there's just not enough supply for demand. Do you think that having designated areas within a city, within a major city, because these are major cities, that, you know, would these small mobile homes help solve it? Or even if someone has a property and wants to lease out a piece of their land for somebody else to have a small mobile home, you know, why or why not do you think that that's okay? I personally don't have a problem with it as long as the mobile home style fits into the home style of the neighborhood. Like, I hate it when I see that, you know, you see Victorian, it's like a neighborhood, it's kind of got old school Victorian homes, or, you know, the small bungalow pre-war style homes, and then you have this huge monstrosity, modern monstrosity. Not that modern homes are bad, but they just don't fit in with a neighborhood like